Nina was the sole bread earner of the family. She would collect pearls from the sea and sell it to the jeweler to earn a living.
Mom, I'm going to collect pearls. I have to buy sweet.
One day, Nina didn't return home at the usual time. This made Induvati worried. She prays for the well-being of her daughter. Even though she was terrified, her trust in God made her believe that wherever she is safe. Days passes by. Indumati doesn't get any information regarding her daughter's whereabouts. Indumati becomes weak as she doesn't eat for days. One day, on the edge of being unconscious, she decides to sell the pearls which she finds in her home. She goes to the jeweler to sell the pearls.
I will consult with the other jewelry person and let you know the true value of it. But for now, I can give you rupees 500. Take this amount.
Thank you so much.
It's okay.
The jeweler decides to contact other jewelers to know the actual price of the pearls.
Hello, sir. How are you, sir? Okay, I hope you are safe, sir. Today I have a problem because one blind lady came and she gave me pearls. I think those pearls are very valuable and I was not able to see the true value of this pearls. So can you help me to tell me the true value of this pearls? When you will be coming now? Sure, sir. Thank you, sir. I hope help me to decide the true value for this pearls because I am facing issues about this. Yes, sir. So, how are you, sir?
Good morning.
How are you, sir?
I'm good.
Please have a seat.
Thanks, mom. Yes, mom, go ahead.
I hope you did not have any trouble while coming.
No, mom, not at all. What's the matter?
Actually, today one of the whole nine lady came to my shop and she brought pearls. I don't know the true value of it, so I gave her rupees 500. Can you help me to know the true value of this?
Please show, get the pearls, please. I want to check it.
Here it is.
This seems to be really worth it. Please check it.
Yes, sir, I agree.
Maybe around, it might worth 10,000. How much did you pay to that pearl?
I gave you rupees 500 and said that I will pay you the true value of its pearls on the next day.
In that deal, there it is. You might get a lot of profit there.
Yes.
What is it?
Sir, but my morals, ethics and conscience does not allow me to deceive someone, sir. So...
Why did you call us then? Follow your moral thing? Then we are living
now. I don't know the true value, so in order to know the true value, I call you, sir.
So you wanted to go with your morality, right? Then go with it. We are living now. Sorry for that. Thanks for inviting me.
Bye. So please don't get angry.
No, not at all.
Next day, he pays the amount to Induman.
Induman Biji, actually, as soon as you came to my shop, and I give you this 500, the true value of this pearls is 10,000. The remaining 9,500, I am giving you, Induman Biji.
Take this. Thank you. God bless you.
It's okay. It's my duty. It's my obligation. Take care of yourself. Don't worry about your daughter. She will be back soon. I pray with God.
In a distant village called Sonpur, a fisherman named Raju finds Meena unconscious on the shore. After the days of treatment given by the fisherman and his wife, Meena recovers and soon becomes conscious.
No, you should take rest, dear. Where am I? Who you are?
We found you near the river banks and you were heavily injured too. So we brought you over here and gave you a nice treatment.
Oh, thank you. Could you do one favor?
Yes.
Get me back to my mom, please.
Okay.
Raju and his wife takes Meena to her mom. Out of gratitude, Indumati gives the money she got after selling the pearls to the fisherman. The fisherman accepts it and is delighted as him and his family were in a great need.
To start with, Indumati was devastated when Meena was missing. But her faith in God kept her going because she believed that God is always on their side who truly believes in Him.
Talking about Mohan, the jeweler, he had the opportunity to cheat Indumati and earn some money, but he decides against it because he believes that cheating only gives a temporary and materialistic joy for a short term, and he also believes that God only supports people who are honest and help others.
Raju, the fisherman, he helps Meena selflessly and without any expectation. His selfless action was rewarded by God in the form of money which was presented to him by Indumati. From the act, we could see that it's people's actions that influence.
From the short film Value Based Across Hindu Religion, the role of Meena indicates the value of dutifulness which is revealed in Ramayana, and she sincerely discharges all her duties and stands as a perfect example of an ideal daughter. The role of Indumati states that faith in God, purity is necessary. In Mahabharata, it is said that if you have faith in God and you shall do your karma action, God shall definitely help you in the hardship. Purity and faith in God is necessary in order to attain God. The role also emphasized that never doubt actions of God. He is capable to change anything in fraction of seconds. The role of the jeweler, Mohan, signifies the importance of following the path of Dharma, not deceiving anyone and being honest with everyone, which is stated in Ramayana. These values are clearly represented in Ramayana. The role of Mohan also signifies that if one wants to do any good to others, that should be done immediately. Mohan wants to give fair value to the Poles, and he did that good immediately without postponing. And similarly, the bad action should be postponed. Who knows that our mind may change and we may not do it. That's why always try to postpone the bad actions and always fulfill the good actions which you want to do it. The rule also emphasizes the path of following the ethical practices in management. He practiced ethical management in business, and his business grows in leaps and bounds in the long run. The role of fisherman states law of karma, kind and love towards fellow beings. Fisherman did the good action by saving the life of Meena, and he ignored catching fishes at that point of time. He gave priority to save the life of the Meena. That is why he got the reward from Indumati. This clearly states that if you do any good action, you shall get good in return, and vice versa holds true. That's why it is said that if you do any good action, that will multiply 100 times and get back to you. And if you do any bad action, that will multiply 100 times and get back to you. That's why it is said, always do good action, you will get definitely good in return. In nutshell, I can say the values which we derive from Hindu religion are as follows: love, purity, dutifulness, honest, dharma, law of karma, service to Guru. Faith in God is necessary to attain God. Thank you. I hope you like this short film.